Hey, Blacklight here. Today I'm gonna talk about this movie called Doctor Strange. And I know other brothers done touch on it, but I got a little different take. Now I'm talking mostly to the white people when I give you my breakdown of the movie. I'm talking about white people and showing you how they trick you. The movie is actually trying to tell the doctors here that Western medicine really is no good. You know, it's really a barbaric way of doing things, and they're using a lot of technology, but they're not using the natural laws that the Most High put inside of man, human. Quite naturally, mankind is going, which is the Caucasian, is going to get a certain amount of these natural laws placed in him, but it's going to be diminished in a whole lot of ways. It's not as going to be as strong as the black man. Now in the movie, it shows this arrogant white doctor called Dr. Strange, but he's an arrogant, but he's a sarcastic, really. He's a sarcastic kind of a guy, you know, quick-witted, you know. And so he is dedicated to his profession. He took the Hippocratic oath of saving lives. But he's not like most of the doctors who don't really, they're not involved in it as much as he is. But the guy got special abilities, you know, got a photographic memory, you know. And he probably, you know, got other qualities. So he, something's happened to his nerve system. And so this doctor, you know, has a problem with his nerve system. And so he's seeking all kinds of solutions. And so eventually he gets wind of some ancient wisdom by a brother. A black man pulled his coat and to some ancient wisdom. One guy went through this process of being a wizard or a you could say a magician, and or alchemist, you know. But he's a master. He wants to become a master. Well, actually, he just wanted to get healed. And so anyway, to make a long story short, he runs into one guy that dealt with this system, this ancient system. But he didn't want to go further into it. He didn't want to become a master. And so the guy directs him to where he must go to find this supreme master. And it turns out to be a woman. But she has a right-hand man, which is a brother, which is a black man. And in the way he teams up with Doctor Strange to defeat their arch enemy. I forgot their names, you know. But he's the master of the dark forces, or the dark dark side of the situation. And they're in combat with each other. Ultimately, Doctor Strange, he's a quick study and a quick learner. And him and the brother team up to, do combat with this guy. But, you know, it's always, a brother helping. It's always an original man or a black man helping the Caucasian. The Lone Ranger got Tonto, So anyway, I'm not going to get off into that, but the main theme of this is what I want y'all to understand, that the he knew how to deal with energy for, he knew how to deal with energy forces and dimensions. He could go into different dimensions. He could go into astral, out of his body, put it like that. But every time he do war or have a battle, they end up killing other people, you know, who they doing battle with. And so my point is this: they talk about death. The real theme of the movie is about death, how to escape death. But if they were so deep into this wisdom, they would know that nothing never dies. Just change forms or change frequencies, but it never dies. So who were they talking about? Dying. They were not talking about, they weren't talking to us, the black people, in that movie. Even though they had black actors in it, they weren't talking about us. And I'm going to come back in the next video and tell you who white people talk about, who they talk to, and who the movie is really talking about, and what the movie is really talking about, and who they really talk to in these movies. This is Black Light Out. Stay tuned for part 2.